All right, hello everyone, and peace of Christ to all of you. Before we start today our topic, I just wanted to inform you I was going to keep the chat disabled, but some don't deserve really to disable the chat for them. Today I have no admins. I will be the only admin, and which mean if you are banned, it's mean I am the one who blocked you. You cannot complain about an admin says he or she blocked me. And I will block you. Anyone in the chat start fighting like kids, I will block you. Anyone speak out of the line, if you are not mature, if you are a kid, get out of here. This is a place for mature people. I have no time to waste. And this is a warning for everybody. Any two people, they start fighting, I will block you. There's a way always, if you don't like somebody posting something, you can put, you click at his name, you can block him, ignore him, you will not see his text. So you have no reason. However, if you are here, a stupid idiot, well, a Christian prince will be all over you. Right? And if you are here to complain, just leave. Actually, before we start, somebody making a video complaining about brother Sam Shamoon, saying Sam Shamoon abusing somebody, like in the way he talk. I say to those people, I mean, this guy, he spent his life preaching the gospel. He stay hours teaching you. And let us say, for the sake of argument, he, you know, he sometimes he lose it. I mean, where is the Christians on you? You don't appreciate the man who is a warrior, who spent his life preaching the gospel, defend the Bible? And the second he say a word, which is you think he is, it is rude, you go crazy over him? You see, if Sam Shamoon was a Muslim, the Muslim, they will make a big mosque for him in the middle of Mecca and will call it Sam Shamoon Mosque. You people don't deserve a man like this. What do you think, he is your waiter? A bunch of kids, and he cannot handle those kids. So they don't appreciate the hours this man he spent from his life, from his age, from his, you know, the guy is poor, he cannot even afford to have a housing. And yet you people go against him. Harut and Marut, get out of here. I just said, anyone will speak stupid, if you are not mature, you are not welcome. Anyone will speak stupid, I will send you free shipping and hand it to Allah. As simple as that. So we spend years from our life trying to fight where nobody can do what we do. Yet the second we say something you don't like, you go crazy. Or somebody block you, the admin block me, as if you did not enter heaven, that's it. I mean, that's it. You know what? Yeah, do you believe it? The admin blocked me, brother. You know, like what? Do we have the door of? Am I Al Khomeini? I will. You will not go to heaven because of me now. It's a chat. It's a stupid chat. And if you don't like anyone, you go to his page. Don't go to his page. He's bad. very funny people, and not only that, you should see my Skype. You see all the idiots texting me in Skype, and I will be like a elementary school a principal. She pulled my hair. No, she pulled my hair first. And there is people who call me names in Skype, and they come in my chat. They are not even ashamed. You hear they are coming to my chat, you know. I don't know what's wrong with people. Anyway, today we will start our topic, and it is about the whale with the tail. Once upon a time, there was a whale, and this whale was in the sea. But not in Islam. In Islam, the whale was not in the sea. In Islam, the whale was in the sky. The whale was in the sky. Muhammad, do you have a question for me? Okay, let us finish our... Don't you see our topic? You cannot wait for the question. And this is exactly what we talk about, you see. They come here, they cannot wait. No, I don't want to hear from you anything. I don't want anyone to call me. I want all the Muslims to call me. Can't you wait? And the complaint, Sam Shamoon, he go crazy sometimes. I mean, you guys look at you. We have patience, you know, what? We just opened a restaurant. Honestly, I said to myself, I'm going to stop coming to this stupid YouTube because of the behavior of people around. I mean, I don't know what to do. I feel like I'm in a nursing home, and a bunch of kids are on me, and everybody he have a finger in his mouth, and I have to give milk to everybody. Go to Zakernek. He will solve any problem you have. First of all, Christian Prince, he will not answer you. And he's very rude. And someday, if you answer to him, Christian, he will get upset. And he will bounce you. And in the top of that, he doesn't start Arabic and he doesn't English. Okay. Go to Zakernek. Don't stop here. Go to a different restaurant, my friend. All right. One of you actually sent me asking for that interpretation for this story. And he said that in one of my videos, I was speaking to a Muslim and I asked him about the seven whales which came from the sky with seven. Now, if we go and try to find the story, actually, in the Islamic translation, they don't show the story as it is in Arabic. This is Ibn Kathir, chapter 5. See, chapter 5, it's called Al-Ma'idah. Al-Ma'idah means the table. All right? If you go to verse 114, you will see supposedly, and this is simply a story starting from the Bible, but the story is not the same. I mean, this guy, Muhammad, he can't even steal the story correctly. Anyway, so the story supposedly that the disciple of Jesus, they told Jesus, okay, we will believe in you, but we want proof. Why you don't ask Allah to send you food from the sky? Food what? From the sky. Hmm. And according to the story, they say that the one who said that is the children of Israel, the Jews, you know, the Jews. The Jews, they want food from the sky. Okay, yeah, give us food from the sky. Can you give us food from the sky? And then, brother, after they say to him, the disciples, as you see here, the Jews, the disciples, they say to Isa, can your Lord send zucchini, tocchini, mikini from the sky? Can your Lord send down to us a table from heaven? But table here is not just an empty table. It's a table full of you know, like food, right? So can your God send us a table? All right. Is the table that has food on it? Some scholars said that the disciples requested this table because they were poor and they breathed. If. Thank God I wasn't exist at that time and I have a YouTube. And then people, they come to me and they ask me for what? I mean, we are just making a video. They are complaining. What if they say we want food from the sky and I could not give it to them? So the scholars, and the funny, they are saying the scholars. I mean, what scholars? The Muslim scholars. How the Muslim scholars, they knew about the story if they are not Christians and they don't have no history book to follow. They don't believe in the Bible. Where do you get this story from? Any Muslim? Anyone have an answer? You see, I started blocking names already. Anyone will say something stupid and silly in the chat, I will block you. Bye-bye. And so they ask Isa to supplicate to Allah. Allah, Isa supplicate, okay, Allah, okay. To send a table of food down to them, open buffet, that they could eat from every day. Like not only once, no. Not only twice, no. Every day, brother. Every day. I like to have a table like this. Fantastic. I love it. Imagine you have a table like this. You go to the kitchen. Always there is food in it. Anytime you want to eat, brother. And then thus, more able to perform act of worship. Open a beef buffet for us. Okay. Like the one in the cruise ship. And this way we can pray more. He said to them, have, you know, fear Allah. Isa said to them, the Messiah said to them, fear Allah. If you are indeed believers. Isa answered them by saying, have fear from Allah and do not ask for this, for it may become a trial for you. But trust in Allah for your perversion. If you are truly a believer. They said, we want to eat from it. Okay, we are stubborn. We want food right now, right now, right now. I want food. I want food right now. I want to eat from it. If we ask Zach and Ike about this story, he will say to you, it's absolutely true. Be good, brother sister. Those disciples, they are very angry. And they really feel angry because they are Jewish. Jewish, they eat a lot. Actually, when a Jewish man, he sleep, his mouth is open. And he put something in his mouth. They eat 24 hours. Zachariah, who told you that the Jews, they eat 24 hours? Did you record somebody in the camera? Have you been a Jewish before?
First of all, you have no idea what to do. And I know that they do it.
What?
I know that they do it.
You know what? Okay, just skip that part. How you know that the Jews, they eat 24 hours? Why they want to eat from it all, every day, every day? Because it is a miracle. And it is because they can make it. Is that correct? Can you speak slower? For the sake of the shame of Allah? Forget about the sin of Allah. And then don't talk about the sin of Allah, because the sin of Allah is sexy. Okay, the sin, the shin of Allah is sexy, and we, and you know it. I know, but who, where this story is coming from? Guilty Prince, it's coming from the Quran. Okay, what is the proof that this story is true? In the Quran. But the Quran, there's no witness for it. We do not need witnesses. The Prophet Muhammad, he said that, it means say that, that's it. Oh, okay. Okay, thank you, Zakanai. Nice to meet you. We call you later. I'm not going to hang up. What do you mean you don't hang up? We just finished the question. I don't care. I'm going to say I'm going to bother you. Okay, don't hang up. Stay with us. Let us see what you can do. What you can do? I'm going to take your socks and I'm going to kill you. And I'm going to go crazy. Okay. I'm not sure what you said. You said you want to kill me? I did not say I want to kill you. I said I'm going to tickle you. Oh, you want to ticklish, ticklish. I'm laughing already. Don't worry. Anyway. And here, brother, it says, and be strong in faith. When we witness, it is descending from heaven as sustains us for us. And then, and we know that you have indeed told us the truth. If. This was a taste for Jesus, brother. They are tasting like, Jesus, are you a prophet of Allah? Okay, if you are a prophet of Allah, do this. Can you do this? Oh boy. And we are going ourselves, we will witness it. I mean, what a job. I like to see anyone, he needs someone to witness like an open buffet, I would be happy to witness it. If you are a person who work in a cruise ship or etc., or you work in a resort and they have a buffet, open buffet, please call me. I will witness for it. As long as you let me eat there for free, I will witness as much as you want. And then testifying that this is a sign from Allah as a proof and evidence, and that you are a prophet. I mean, this guy, supposedly Isa in the Quran, they call him Isa, we don't know who's he. This guy, he made the dead alive. He made the blind see. He healed the leper, which means he healed the one have corona. He made the one who cannot walk. He can tell you what you had in your house, and all of this is not enough for those people. Now, after all what he did, they want this one. Do it or leave it. Yeah, no more admin, TP, no more admin. Sorry, I took all the admin off so I can block people. They will not complain. Because you guys, when you block somebody, they complain and they send me messages. Now they knew it is me who blocked them. They will not complain about people. And then, brother. And this is will be proof from you. Okay. And then Isa, he asked Allah. And Allah told Isa, okay, I'm going to send it down upon you. Huh? I will send it. What do you want more? But here in the story, the story is fishy. Let us see. Does it show anywhere the word fish? Not fish, whale. No whale. What happened? Let us see the word fish.
If.
He also said, so the angels brought a table down containing seven fish and seven pieces of bread. But it doesn't say that in Arabic. In Arabic, it doesn't say seven pieces in Arabic. Seven pieces of bread. It says seven big loaves and seven whale. Just to show you how they lie in the translation, and the reason they lie in the translation is just to make you able to swallow the stupid lie. This is Ibn Kathir in Arabic, the same book, the same exact book. This is the official government website of the Kingdom of Jordan. Anyone who knows Arabic, you will see it says there that Allah He sent down فَأَقْبَلَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ تَطِيرُ بِمَائِدَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ عَلَيْهَا سَبْعَةُ أَحْوَاتٍ وَسَبْعَةُ أَرْغِفَةٍ So Allah He sent the angels flying with a table from the sky, has on it seven wheel and seven loof. Now let us do English translation. Let us see. Translate to English. Okay. Where is the wheel? I'm looking where from this Rizakna. Where is the wheel? I don't see the wheel. Do you see the wheel? What happened in the translation? Okay, let us search for the word seven to make it easier. Seven. Well, the translation is not showing the word wheel. I think it's coming wrong, and because it says ahwat, so the Google could not get it correctly. Let us do something else. We will use Google translation, but the sentence alone, just to show you. I mean, you know, let us see this. Anyone who speaks Arabic can see it right away, but it says it clearly, seven wheel. Let us do this. We will open, maybe if we copy one line that can make a difference, we will see. All right, we will copy. Let us see. I will copy the line, you know, and we will take it to Google Translation. Right in the front of your eye. Let us see if this time is going to come correctly. See? Now it's coming good. Seven wheels and seven loaves. Do you see it? We copy from Ibn Kathir the text exactly. So it is seven wheels and seven loaves. I have a question to the Muslims. Muhammad is stuck with number seven. I understand. Allah sent seven sandwiches, or seven wheel. I mean, why He sent seven loaves with it? Actually, why He sent seven wheel? Any Muslim can answer? Just to make the story simple for you, to show you the stupidity. You see, this story is coming from the Bible, where Jesus blessed the food which they have. They have little food with them. It's not like He asked God send us, you know, a wheel, and you know. thousands of people, they are coming to meet Jesus, to hear him. And they have little food. And Jesus, he made a miracle. He blessed the food they have. And that food was enough that as much they eat from it, it still is coming. And I will tell you why the story here is stupid. In the Bible, it's just a story about this is what they have with them. He blessed it. He did not like it, choose how many they have with them. This is what they have. He blessed it, and they eat from it, and they keep eating from the same container. As long this is a miracle was done for the disciple. How many disciples Jesus have? 12. All right. If we have a big, big, huge whale, just to make him more fancy, you know, and there are 12 men. Why they need 7 whale, especially if this whale, as you eat from it, it's still the same. Because if it's 7 or 1, will not make any difference. 1 is enough to feed 100, 200 maybe. We don't know like how big this whale is. Usually, a whale, you know, can be thousands of kilograms, right? So, what this story is about? Any Muslim can tell us? Yeah, whale, we are not saying wheels. Any Muslim can tell us what this is behind. I mean, why 7? If there are 12 men, the tail of the whale alone is going to feed them for a month. So what they will do with 7? And okay, hold on. So after they finish eating for the meal, and the whale is in the table, they go back, they sleep, they come back, the whale is still there, they do not need to put the meat in the refrigerator or anything. If this is the case, we should have the whale until now. Any whale Muslim here can answer us? Who is a whale Muslim here? He can answer this whale question. This question needs a big Muslim. You never had a whale meat? Because you are not the Muslim. Any Muhammadan? Zach and Nick, I thought you did not hang up. What happened?
Get the breath. I'm waiting for you. And you did me the mistake, I'm going to get you with it.
Okay, what is the mistake I made, man?
First of all, those 7 whales, they are big whales. Yes, exactly. But who said that the disciple of Jesus at that time, they were like us?
What do you mean?
They were very big.
Like how big?
I will give you an example. Do you know Brother Sam Samoon?
Who?
Brother Sam Samoon.
Sam Samoon, yeah, what about him?
They are even bigger than him.
Okay, but Sam Shamoon don't eat a whale, man. Like he can eat a watermelon alone, maybe. He can eat a sardine, but not a whale.
Exactly. Because Sam Shamoon, he lost his appetite since he became your friend.
We are not really friends. I mean, I never met him, but anyway, he's my brother.
Exactly. And you guys didn't even know to eat.
Okay, but how in the world they need all this food, man? I mean, you are saying to me they are so big. How big they are?
In the time of Adam. Adam was 90 meter.
90 or 30?
30.
So why you made it 90?
I was exaggerating.
Ah, you were exaggerating. Okay, well, nothing new. You are following the step of the prophet.
I'm not following the step of the prophet. I'm following his tail.
Oh, you are following what?
His tail.
But are you saying the prophet, he have a tail?
You are stupid in English and stupid in Arabic. I follow his tail, I mean I follow his steps.
But I just said to you, you follow his step, you said I follow his tail.
What's wrong with you? Exactly. I'm trying to make you upset.
I get you. Any Muslim? Hello? What is this? And why you Muslims, you change the translation from seven whale to seven fish? Seven fish? I mean, since when the whale became a fish? That's a fishy translation, brother. Where is the guy, Mahmoud? Mahmoud, where are you, Mahmoud? You wanna what? What do you want, my friend? Muhammad, Muhammad, what do you want? Accept a call. My Skype is not open. Are you calling me all this time? The poor guy. He's calling me all this time. Didn't you ask first if his Skype is open, my friend? Poor you. I feel sorry for you now. Okay, let me go to Skype for just for you. Okay, Muhammad, you can call me right now. Only Muhammad, please call me, no one else. Give me a text to be sure that this is you, my friend. Oh, here we go, he's missed call. All right. I'm calling you, Muhammad. Answer, please.
Hello?
Yes, my friend, go ahead.
Okay. I have one question for you. You can have one question for me.
No, we have a topic. You don't want to talk about the topic?
Hello?
You don't want to talk about the topic?
Listen, if you can answer my question, then you're... Come on, then, are you scared?
I'm sure you're scared. Maybe you have a big whale with you.
Listen, answer my question, then I'll answer your question.
Wallah. Okay, I asked you the question. Here we go. What do you think about the whale? Here we go. Go ahead.
What's the verse called? Qur'an.
It's called Qur'an, yeah.
Do you
want to
answer my question?
You did not ask me a question. I am the one who have a question about the whale. Go
okay,
ahead.
I have a question.
Okay, go ahead. Okay, go ahead. What's your question?
How many women came to the tomb after Jesus' crucifixion?
How many women?
Okay, John chapter 1, chapter John 21, only Mary Magdalene. Gospel of Matthew. Magdalene and another Mary.
All right.
Gospel of Mark, Mary Magdalene, Mary, James, and Salome. And Luke, five more a group. So how many women visited the tomb? One, two, three, four, a group. You tell me.
Okay, let me ask you. So you are saying if this is wrong, that's mean the number is wrong. That's mean the book is corrupt, correct? If the number are...
Contradiction.
Thank you very much. So yes. I'm going. Okay, I will go with you. I hope you will not change your mind in 2 seconds. I will answer you, but everybody will laugh. Everybody will laugh. Hold on. It's my time to answer. Everybody will laugh at you in a second. How many angels they spoke to Mary in the Quran? One angel or many angels?
Answer my question.
I'm answering you. You see, you are the one who said that if there are many, if there is contradiction, if there is here one and there is two, that's mean they are this is the correct book. So I'm asking you, how many angels they came and they spoke to Mary? One or many?
Are we talking about the Bible or are we talking about the Quran?
We are talking about both, my friend. I am answering you because you are a hypocrite and now you will not accept. Now you will not accept your logic. Do you accept your logic or you back up and you kiss my hand? You apologize for being stupid. Listen. First of all, in the Bible, I'm answering you. In the Bible, everyone reporting the story as important as it is. As an example, when Jesus in the cross.
No.
This is why it's four books. Listen.
Different names.
There's not different names. No, don't lie. Secondly.
Yes, I'm not lying.
Why? Okay. I'm asking you. In the Quran, was the angels one angel who spoke to Mary or many angels?
There are four books.
If each one of them reporting what is not mentioned in the other book, this is why there are four books.
Listen.
You're a hypocrite now. I want you to answer me. How many angels? I answered you. This is my answer. You don't like it? It's up to you. This is my answer. You see, this is why there are four books. If they are reporting exactly word by word, then why we have four books?
No, they are not different numbers.
No, they are not. And stop lying. Secondly, why you don't answer? Here we go. The angels came to Miriam and they said to her,
Or an angel came to Mary. You're scared of your own Bible.
You coward. Here we go. Your logic.
One angel he spoke to Mary
or many angels? I'm asking you.
Answer my question first. Then
I answered you. Everyone in the book, every book report the story to complete the other story.
This is my answer.
This is my answer. Here we go. But in your Quran, we have only one reporter. One reporter. So you cannot say this is different book reporting what is missing in the other story.
In Gospel of Luke, there's a Joanna.
Listen. Why you don't answer? I'm asking you.
I
answer you. They are reporting what is not mentioned in the other book. Now I'm asking you. We have one book. It's called the Quran. You are not answering. You are a coward. How many angels? Everybody is my witness. Here we go. He got his prophet busted. Muhammad is a fraud. Muhammad is a fraud.
There's a salon.
No problem, my friend. This is why they are reporting the story for you that they are. No. Here we go. Let me tell you more information. Let me tell you more information. And so, simply, did you read the interpretation for the verse?
I have it with me right now.
No. Me and you, if we read the interpretation for the verse according to the Christians, and if we read the interpretation for the Quran persons. According to Muslim, do you accept?
Okay, hold on.
I'm asking you, do you accept the interpretation for the Bible according to the Christian?
Listen,
or you want to give your own interpretation?
Don't you
want to
read the verse itself?
I answered you. Now I'm asking you,
okay.
Do you accept the interpretation of the Christians or you want to have your own interpretation?
No, I want the verse. I don't want any interpretation, my friend.
It's not up to you because this is my belief, not your belief. So you are asking me. That's me. You are asking me for an interpretation. Are you stupid or what? Did you ask me for my interpretation or not? This is why you are calling me. This is why you are calling me, and I answered you. Now I want the same question. The same question. How many angels they spoke to Mary? One or many?
Give me the verse.
Chapter 19, verse number 171. How many angels? Chapter 19, verse number 17. It says here that Allah, He sent a spirit to Mary, and the spirit spoke to her. Okay.
Chapter 19, okay.
All right. So, is that, it says a spirit there, right?
Chapter 19 what?
It says a spirit.
You ran off my question, by the way.
17. Okay, no, I answered you. You are, you know...
No, you have enough, my friend. I'll leave it for the...
All right. The question is the following. Very simple. Was one angel or many angels spoke to Mary?
Give me the verse first, so I can...
I am asking you, my friend. I'm asking you. Give me an answer. One or many first. Why you don't answer?
Many, but in different times.
Ah, okay. So I can say the same to you. Oh, hold on. You know, so if I say the same to you, different time. Okay, hold on. First of all, I want you to show me who is the one who said it is different time. You are a liar, and we cannot find that in any interpretation.
I'll show you.
Okay, show me the interpretation.
Give me the verse. Give me both of the verses, my friend.
No. You know the answer. So supposed to, you know what verses. So how you, are you saying you are answering me without knowing the Bible? Are you saying you are answering me without knowing the verses? Are you saying you are answering me but you do not know what verses I'm talking about?
See, if you do want my answer.
Yeah, I'm asking you. I want an answer. Yes. Do you know the verses I'm talking about or not? Do you know the answer you are talking about or not?
Listen to me. Listen, calm down, fam. In your Bible, it says when they visited the tomb, and then it says the names. In the Quran, it's ambiguous. It does not say where, what place.
Let me get you busted. This is the time, the first time Sharif received the message. Because if this is the second time, let me show you how stupid you are. You see, everyone talking his time, please. Just to show you how stupid you are. You just said that the story is reported to Mary many times. So why Mary is surprised in the second time and in the third time? So each time they say to her the story, she say, no way. Huh?
She could say, why not? How can I have a son with no man?
Okay, so she heard the news. Who delivered the news to her? Give me the name.
What's wrong with that?
Who is the one who delivered the news to Mary that she is going to have a son?
Both. They gave, the first one was the good tidings, the other one was a...
Who is the one who gave, please don't give me what both. Who is the one who gave, who is the one who
give
gave?
Me the verse. I'll read it for you.
You don't know what verse we are talking about?
I don't know, my friend. You give me the verse.
Okay, chapter 19, verse number 17.
Okay, let me go, wait. Okay. Yeah, I haven't asked my question, but okay.
According to you, you are a Mohammedan. Yes. Nobody can answer a Mohammedan, as usual.
I hope your followers are not blind.
Yeah, they can see.
Okay. Okay. That's the first verse. This is Gabriel. Okay, seclusion. Okay, Gabriel.
This is Gabriel.
Give me the other verse.
This is Gabriel. Gabriel.
Yes.
Where it says
19:17. Yes.
Okay. Where it says this is Gabriel.
Our angel. Everyone in Islamic traditions knows that it's Gabriel.
So you Muslims. You follow tradition or you follow the Quran? Where in the
Give
Quran?
Give me the other verse that shows.
Hold on.
Give me
so
the
you.
Verse.
But you said. So you said now. This is Jibril speaking to her, right?
Yes, it says our angel, one angel. Yes.
All right.
Give me the other verse.
There's no other verse. I have to make one.
There are different times.
You will show me different time. How is different time?
Different time. One came after the other one.
All right. Let us see if this is different time. Chapter 3, verse number 42.
3, verse number 42. 3. Okay.
3.
Number 42. Okay. I'll show you. Okay. In the first verse you gave me, it specifically says she took in seclusion from them. In the other one, It does not say anything about seclusion. Yes.
It doesn't say that. Okay, so
it does not say that.
Okay, hold on. So what is that?
Yes.
So she did not take she did not take seclusion. I'm not talking about taking seclusion. I'm talking about how many they came and they tell her that you will have a child. His name is the Messiah.
They came one off. They came another time, a different time.
So why she is being surprised? Okay, let me. Everybody will be. Everybody will be laughing at you if she. If this is. Okay, no, no, don't give me a story. So why she is surprised if this is the second time?
Where does she say she's surprised? She just asked the same question.
Here we go. You see, chapter 19, verse number 17. It says, "So he came to her and he told her. He came, appeared to her." And she said to him, I seek refuge from Allah. He said, you are going to have a child. She said, how am I going to have a child? Verse number 20. Do you see it in the screen?
Yes, I see, yes.
Okay. If we go to the other chapter, If we go to the other chapter, chapter number 3, verse number 47, she said, oh my Lord, how shall I have a son when no man has ever touched me?
Okay.
Okay.
So, In this verse, in the chapter 3:1, where does it say, where does it talk about her childbirth?
What? He's saying he would go. Hold on, it says, but before she did not have the baby yet. Are you crazy? What birth? What birth?
Listen,
what
birth? Listen,
this is when she received the news. Abdul, listen, this is when she received the news. This is no birth yet. There's no birth. This is the first time she received the news.
Do you want my answer?
Yeah, so the angels, they came and they said to her, we are here to give you glad tidings.
I'll give you my answer.
Go ahead.
The chapter 3:1. This happened when she was in the temple. Yes. Where did it say she was in seclusion?
Where it says that she was in the temple in the verse?
No, I'm just saying. Listen, where does it say she was sitting in a palm tree where she was given birth?
Abdul, don't share the topic. Don't share the topic. Which, you see, the same verses, both of them, she is acting as she never heard this before.
No.
Okay, hold on. Okay, then read for me.
In chapter 19, in seclusion. In the other one, in the chapter 19, she's sitting on a palm tree.
Hold on, but because there is reporting that this is 9 months after, my friend. I'm not talking about 9 months after. I'm talking about, listen, Abdul, this is about 9 months after. This is not the question. I am talking about 9 months before, not 9 months after. So when the angels came to her, it was an angel or angels?
Okay, where's the childbirth situation?
What type of thought? I'm asking you, is that...
If it's the same story...
Uh-huh.
Then where is the given birth and the palm tree and all that?
I will help you. You see, just to show you how foolish you are. You are a person who copy paste, because this is your logic. You get yourself busted.
I'm giving you logic.
No, you did not give me an answer. It says angels, and this is the same book. So there is no way this
happened before the first. The chapter 3:1 happened before the 19:1.
Chapter 3, guys. Chapter 3, verse number 45 happened before verse number 20. But this is mean that there's a lie.
Yes.
Because why she is surprised? How? Why she is surprised? And if she heard that before?
Oh my God! Listen, my friend. Do you want to listen to me?
I'm listening. Why she is surprised?
Just
she heard that already.
She asked the question does not mean she's surprised.
Okay.
Friend.
Here we go. She said, oh my Lord, how shall I have a son? And the same thing she said in chapter 19, verse number 20. The same exactly.
Okay. 19:17. Let me go. So she conceived him, and 19:22, she conceived him, and she withdrew with him to a remote place, and the pains of childbirth drove her to the trunk of a palm tree.
Okay.
That's chapter 19.
Okay.
Chapter 3, There's no mention of any childbirth at all.
Who care?
It's just a
who care? Listen, who care? This is the first time. This is the first time she heard the news, right?
Glad tidings, yes.
Okay, so why she is asking the same question and she is already been taught, and why Allah is sending? Okay, and no, and why Allah sending the angels to say the same again? What does that mean? Why? I mean, the first time he came already, Allah, he made her breathe it, right? So why Allah sending the angels again? If you are saying, you are saying to me, okay, just to show you, hold on.
The story of the child.
Just to show you how funny what you say.
Let me ask you, hold on.
Let me show you. You say the chapter
you
3.
You don't know nothing you're talking
chapter about. 3. You said chapter 3, verse number 40.
It's ambiguous, like you.
Okay, no problem. Okay, let me ask you. When Allah He told her by the angels that you will have a son, did she become already pregnant by that or not?
Huh?
Did she carry a child already when Allah He said that to her?
Where does it say it?
Because here it says, by the way, it doesn't even. This is how stupid the Quran. It says, "Oh my Lord,
you tell me
if the angels, listen, it's in the front of you. It's in the front of you. When Allah He said to her that you are going to have a child, His name is the Messiah. All right?
Yes.
Did He made her carry the child immediately or not?
Where is it?
I'm asking what you, is that where Allah made Mary carry a child inside her? Yes or no?
Give me the verse, my friend.
The same chapter 3, verse number 45, yes. 46, 47.
47, yes.
Okay, so did she carry a child when Allah He said to her this? Did she carry a child immediately or later?
She carried later, yes.
Later?
Yes.
What is the proof?
Where is the story of the childhood then? Tell me. You bring the proof. You are making
Okay. Oh, hold on. See, you are the one who said she carried the child later, correct?
Yes.
All right. So why she is surprised when she carried the child?
This guy, I think you're sick in the head, my friend. Just because she said, "How can I have a son when no man has touched me?" does not mean that she's in childbirth.
What?
Okay, that does not give. That is not evidence, my friend.
What do you mean?
No.
Hold on. Okay, you see, if we go to chapter 21, just to show you how silly you are, you see, I have many traps for you, waiting for you. Everybody will die laughing at this video.
Chapter 21, verse number 91.
Did he breathe immediately? Because you are the one who said that when the spirit came to her, this is not the first time, this is the second time.
This is another chapter, you know.
This is another chapter, yeah. No problem. Okay,
this is one angel.
Okay, we will see which one is the one who made her carry the child.
This is one angel.
No problem. Which one? You are the one who said everybody heard you.
Okay.
Okay. So now
who? I'm talking about chapter 3, okay?
Okay. No problem. Who is the one who made Mary carry a child? Give me his name.
Allah blew a spirit into her. What are you talking about?
All right. But you said to me, in chapter 19, verse number 20, that the spirit there is Jibreel.
Yes.
All right. But in
chapter 19,
verse number 17, I ask you, who is the spirit which appeared to Mary as a man? You said,
yes.
This is Jibreel, correct?
Okay.
Okay, wonderful. In chapter 21, verse number 91, the same spirit is Jibreel, right?
Yes.
All right. So Allah, by the way, did he say yes? He said yes. Remember, he said yes.
What's your point, man?
Okay, hold on. You just said yes, but according to the verse, Allah he blew into Mary's vagina from Jibreel.
No, you're wrong.
You are the one who said yes a second ago. You are the one who said,
no,
I asked you.
I asked you,
is that a spirit, Jibreel?
No,
you said yes.
No, I said Those two chapters, there's only one angel, and that one angel is Gabriel.
No problem. I ask you, who is this? I ask you, the word there, it says a spirit. Who is the spirit? You said Jibreel. Okay, I said again to you.
Yes.
It's recorded. I said, okay, chapter 21, verse number 91, it says a spirit again. Is that Jibreel? You said yes.
How many angels?
No, hold on. We are proving, we are getting you busted more and more. Listen. So, 20, so you are the one who said yes when I asked you about chapter 21, verse number 91. You said, I ask you, is that Jibreel, the spirit? You said, yes. But the verse saying that Allah, he created Jesus by blowing from the spirit, which means he's blowing from Jibreel.
No. Okay, he blew into her.
From Jibreel.
Through angel. Okay.
From the angel?
What's your point?
So Allah, he blew Jibreel inside Mary?
What's your point?
You are the, I ask you, that's my point. I say to you, is that a spirit in chapter 21, verse 91, Jibreel? You said yes.
Yes, okay.
Okay, but the verse saying that Allah, he blow into Mary, vagina, Jibreel. That's mean, according to you, Jibreel enter into vagina of Mary.
No, God, it says guarded farjaha, basically an expression.
This is not the question. No, farjaha yes. Is a vagina, don't lie. Secondly,
No.
I will go with you. No problem. You can lie as much as you want. But here we have a problem.
I'm not lying.
You said the word spirit is Jibreel. You are the one who said that.
Yes.
Okay, so Allah, he blew from Jibreel into her. Explain to us that.
We blew into her through our angel.
Through the angel?
Through our angel, the angel brought the spirit. Okay, and
no, it doesn't say that. I ask you, the spirit.
First,
I ask you, who is the spirit? You coward! You coward! Liar! You cannot even maintain. You cannot maintain your lie for 5 minutes. I ask you, who is the spirit? You said Jibreel. But the verse Listen to me.
I maintain that.
Okay, so Jibreel is the spirit.
The verse
says, so we blow into her vagina from our spirit.
Your first point was angels and one angel.
How no problem.
And now you're talking about
we blew. We are showing you that you are mistaken and you are lying. Because you are the one who said that the angels and there is one angel, but the fact when the angel, which is Jibreel, supposed to be according to you, first hold on, okay.
Listen.
You have two problems now. According to you, the spirit is Jibreel. Everybody heard you saying that, and now we find that Jesus is created from Jibreel, according to you.
Huh?
Jesus was created from Jibreel, according to you.
No, we blew through our angel. Okay. He brought the spirit.
So who is the one? Okay, hold on. Are you saying the one who blew into Mary, it is Jibreel?
Listen, my friend.
No, I'm listening. I want an answer. Who is the one who blew into Mary, Jibreel or Allah?
Okay. No. It says Ruhina, spirit.
This is not the question. This is not the question. Who is the one?
Who? The chapter. I got it wrong.
What? How you get it wrong? You got it wrong.
It says Ruhina.
Ah, he got it wrong, guys. He was busted all this time. So all this time you are debating me.
What are you talking about?
Okay, apologize. Okay, apologize and say. Okay, apologize and say I was stupid. Say it, please. Apologize for lying to me all those 10 minutes. You wasted my time. I lost my voice screaming at you. And you kept saying to me now. And now you are saying to me you were wrong. Why you were wrong?
Your first argument was angels.
Okay, yeah. Okay, yeah. Because we are looking. Are you blind? Are you blind? Are you blind? Because you are the one who said to me that the spirit is Jibreel, correct?
It says Ruhina.
Okay.
It does not say.
But it says,
okay, and if it is, and what?
Hold on, my
What's
friend.
Your point?
Okay, it says, guys, it says Ruhana. It says Ruhana, just to show you how stupid you are. But it's chapter 19, verse number 17, it says Ruhana too.
Where's the contradiction?
You say, don't change. You say it.
You say it.
This is not Jibreel. This is the spirit of Allah, because it says Ruhana, right? But I asked you before about chapter 19, verse number 17. It says Ruhana too, which means our spirit.
It says Ruhana. You liar. It says Ruhana.
Yes, it's lying. The same word.
You're liar.
It's the same word.
It says Ruhana. I'm looking at it right now.
Yeah.
It says Ruhana.
Yeah, it's what you said. You said to me that you are wrong about this one because it says Ruhana.
It's one Ruh. What's wrong with you?
Okay, but not that. This is not the question. Are you stupid or what? I ask you. You said you are wrong about it, chapter 21, verse number 91. This is not Jibreel, correct? Yes or no?
Listen, my friend.
Did you say you are wrong? Did you say you are wrong? Yes or no?
Tell me, what's your first question?
We are talking about how many angels, and this will prove it.
Yes.
Okay.
And now you're talking about Gabriel.
You are trying to escape the disaster. You made a big poo-poo. Now answer. You said here the word Ruhana.
You have to confuse people, my friend.
Abdul, you are a coward. You are trying to run. Are you going to hang up? Are you going to go? I want an answer.
I'm not running.
All right.
You went from my bag.
Chapter 21, verse number 91. You said that here that this word is about Ruhana.
Okay.
You said this is not Jibreel. You are mistaken. Why you said that? You said because it says Ruhana.
Listen to me, calm down. in chapter 21, Ruhana, one spirit.
Okay.
In 1917, Ruhana, one spirit.
Okay.
So where are the multiple spirits you're talking about?
You said, I ask you, is that Jibreel? You said yes.
And? Yes, yeah. It is.
But you apologized a second ago. You said in chapter 21.
Because I was confused by you. You said your first question.
Okay, you said, but you said, you idiot, you said, listen, it's recorded.
It's recorded.
Everybody is dying laughing. Listen, you said here, this is cannot be Jibreel because it says Ruhana. You said that, it's recorded. You said this is cannot be Jibreel because it says Ruhana.
Listen to me. What was your first question?
This is what you said. Don't change the topic. You said this is going to be Jibreel because it says Ruhana. This is what you said to me.
It is Jibreel. Okay.
Is it Jibreel or not?
Yes.
Okay. Chapter 21, verse number 91. Is it Jibreel or not?
Yes.
Okay. So Allah...
That's the multiple spirits you're talking about.
So Allah created the Messiah from Jibreel?
Through Jibreel.
Through Jibreel. How? Explain to us. How?
The creation was a transportation. You know what I mean?
He was a transportation.
Yes. Listen.
Okay. What he transport?
Through Jibreel, basically.
Okay. Where it says through Jibreel? Yes. Are you corrupting the Quran? Where it says through Jibreel? There's only one way. I'm asking you, what Jibreel did here? Chapter 21, verse number 91. Don't tell me anyways. I want an answer.
Chapter 1, what?
You do not know where?
Where is the contradiction you're talking about?
I'm asking you. Okay, I'm asking you. What Allah did through Jibreel. Allah sent him. Okay. It says here, we breathe into her of our spirit. But you say this is Jibreel.
Yes.
Okay, so
he
Allah
blew into
so,
her.
Okay, he blew
and the next one?
He must say through, don't lie. It doesn't say through.
It says through. It says through.
Okay, hold on.
We sent to her.
Hold on, you are a potato liar. It says فَنَفَخْنَا فِيهَا مِنْ رُوحِنَا from our spirit. Why you are lying?
فَنَفَخْ into her of
See?
And
apologize.
Because according to you, Allah sent many angels in one verse,
and here is one angel. His name is Jibreel. And now look what happened. Hold on. You, according to you, angel. According to you, this is Jibreel, and Allah insert
it's
Jibreel.
The same angel. And you ran away from
look,
that
look,
Bible.
Look,
okay,
look, look, what you are, look what you are saying. You, Allah inserted Allah inserted Jibreel inside Mary. Explain to us how this happened.
Through.
Where it says through? You are a liar. Where it says through?
You are annoying.
You know what? Listen. Show me the word through. I will shave my mustache and my beard, which is 20 foot tall.
What? Okay, listen to me. Listen to me.
Mm.
Listen to me. Uh-huh. What is the word used?
Yeah. It says فَنَفَخْنَا فِيهِ. First of all, you Somalian boy, you don't speak Arabic, so don't act like you know Arabic. I'm asking you now.
Okay.
How in the world? Okay. Hold on. فَنَفَخْنَا فِيهَا مِنْ رُوحِنَا. مِنْ رُوحِنَا. What does that mean? Explain to me. مِنْ mean from.
Our spirit.
From. Okay. From our spirit. Okay. So he blew from our spirit.
Listen.
He blew from where?
Listen. Okay.
Hey, our
first
spirit.
First question,
okay, this spirit is
how many
this.
Angels?
This spirit is what.
It's in YouTube, my friend.
I showed. Okay, listen. No, you see.
That question.
Everybody is laughing at you. You are trying to run away. You are trying to run away because this is embarrassing. This is embarrassing. One verse in the Quran says many angels.
How did Jibreel create Jesus? That's what you're coming to now.
No. I'm showing you the stupidity because because you are the one who said that in chapter 3, verse number 45, it was delivered first. Hold on. Let me ask you. Do you know something called the Quran?
I am a human. Listen.
You are a human?
I am a human. If I say it's Jibreel or not, I'm a human. I'm fallible.
So what does
it
that mean?
It says Ruhana in there.
Hold on. What does that mean? I don't understand. What do you mean you are a human? What does that mean?
You're trying to say, oh.
So you are giving me all this time. You are asking me. So all this. Okay. So all this time. All this time. Okay. Hold on. All this time you are giving me a false answer, and now you are saying to me, I am a human. Is that what you are saying?
False answer you took, Matt. You ran away from both my questions.
No, it's you who ran. It is you who is running away. Now listen. You are the one who said,
question,
okay, let me repeat the question again. Everybody is laughing. You say that chapter 3, verse number 40, chapter 3, verse number 45, it was sent first, correct?
My God, man.
Yes
what?
Or no? Yes or no?
This is a different... This has nothing to do with the two other chapters.
No, you are the one who said that. You are the one who said that, you idiot. Let me laugh. Let me show everybody. Okay. But according to Islam, hold on. According to Islam. You Muslims, you have something. Let us see who is running, my friend. Everybody is laughing. According to Islam, according to your religion, which one came first, chapter 21 or chapter 3?
Chapter 3.
Okay, what if I get you busted?
Wait.
You see, all your answer is stupid from the beginning. Because the chapter 21,
you went from 21, potato.
Chapter 21, it is a chapter 73 in the real Quran. A chapter 3 came at the end of the Quran, chapter 89. Quran, according to Revelation chapter 3, listen to me.
The story came first.
We are talking about the chapter of Al-Imran. It came in chapter. According to the true revelation, it is 89. You get busted. According to your revelation, it was sent. Okay, hold on. No, you are the one. You got busted. Listen. So when I ask you, How the Quran, one verse, I answered you, I answered you. You are the coward, yes. And you got busted.
Because
and,
I got you busted there.
Well, here we go. I challenge you to post this video on your channel. Okay, let me ask you. Do you promise me to post this video on your channel?
Do you? Third question.
Ah, so I say I made you confused. So why you lie to me? You said to me chapter 3.
You ran away from
why you lie? Okay,
you
listen. Okay, let us go to zero. Let us go to zero. Let's go zero. Why you did lie to me and you say chapter 3 came first?
Let's start again.
Chapter 3. You said I answered you. Chapter 3, you said
so
this
you
is king first.
You
said this is the first news. You said that this is the first news. But this is the chapter came way after chapter 21. Why are you lying?
Are you a grown man?
Get lost.
Are you a grown man?
And if you are a man, pause this video on your channel, coward potato. I'm not going to scream all day. And you want to call me? Coward and liar. Chapter 3, verse number 45 was given first. Really? But this is a chapter came way after chapter 21. As you see, chapter 21, it was revealed in Mecca. And the real order of it is a chapter number 73. While chapter number 3 is 89. Do you know how many verses between them? 73 and 89. And this is was revealed in Al-Madinah. So when I ask you, how come here it says angels, there it says an angel? According to you, because I asked you, who is this Ruhana? You said this is Jibreel. Okay, so Jibreel is the one who came. Which one is of them is first? You said this one. But this one came many years after. And here reporting clearly twice that the angels spoke to Mary. Angels, read chapter 3, verse number 42, and chapter 45. In chapter 21, it says that our spirit came to Mary and appear in front of her. You know, when a Muslim, he tries to lie, he do his best, but he cannot. And he tried to escape from the disaster because it says we breathe into her from our spirit. And this is appear again in chapter 66, verse number 12. And when we ask them, who is this spirit? They say, this is Jibreel. But this is mean Allah, he created Jesus from Jibreel. Because he said, and we breathe into her of our spirit. The coward liar, he said, through. So what a through? Allah, he put Jibreel and he blew in his nose, and then the spirit came from his mouth to Mary. Go and learn how to lie, my friend. Go learn from your prophet. And if you go and read the interpretation for those verses you are speaking about the Bible, everybody will laugh at you. We have four books. And each one of them reporting what is not reported in the other one. This is why they are four. Otherwise, there's no need for a second book, or third, or even fourth. If we are going to write exactly everything the same, then there is no need for the second one. So the disciple, they report what is not reported there. But here we have one reporter, his name is Allah. And look, he says, I am just a human, I make mistakes. So you are answering me all these lies based on mistakes. So he was sure. He was sure until we spank him and we made him red. All the report between the Gospels, they are in total agreement. If we have four journalists writing a story, if the four they write exactly the same, that means they are copying each other. And remember that those books are written not even in order, like in the same time. So the one who is writing after the first one, he knew what is written there. And he's completing the story. Not contradicting the story. Put the Quran in front of us is a joke. We ask them, who is the spirit? They say, this is Jibreel. But Jesus created from that spirit. That's mean the one who created Jesus is Jibreel. That's make them Jehovah's Witnesses. In the first book, he mentioned the important name in the book of Matthew, in the book of John. He thinks those are the important one. The other one, he added more names because simply he believes you should not, I should add them because there they are not mentioned. That's the whole story. If I say, well, I was walking yesterday and I saw Sam Shamoon and I said to him, when you are going to go live? And then, 2 weeks after, I say, well, I was walking and I saw Sam Shamoon and David Wood, and I said to him, when you are going to go live on air? Simply, I just added information I did not mention before. As simple as that. But you see here how the Muslims, they cannot handle their own drugs. Not only the angels are different, everything in the Quran is different. How many days Allah created the earth and the heaven? In one verse it says 6, in the other verse it says 8. If we go in the hadith, and I will go with his logic, if I go in the hadith, you will see this. Just to show you that this person should leave Islam immediately, using his logic, not my logic. Muhammad, he said that Allah, he created the, you know, the dust in Saturday, the clay in Saturday. He created the mountains in Sunday. He created the trees in Monday. He created the things entirely in labor in Tuesday. He created the light in Wednesday, and he caused the animals to spread in Tuesday. And he created Adam in a Friday afternoon. But this is 8 days. This is what? 8 days. How many times the Quran says that Allah created the earth in 6 days and everything, and then he went up to the sky and he sat in the top of his chair. Here we go. This is your logic. Those are 8 days. If you are stupid, you do not know how to count, let me count for you. Open your mouth and say with me. Saturday, number one. Sunday number two. Monday number three. I'm singing it for you because you are slow. Tuesday number four. Wednesday number five. Tuesday number six. And he created Adam Friday afternoon number seven. So did Allah created the earth and the heaven in 7 days or in 6 days? If you are an honest man, you leave Islam immediately, Mahmoud, Mahmoud. And this is not different reporter. Remember, the Quran reported by Muhammad, the Hadith reported by Muhammad. Because Muhammad is talking here. Who's talking? Allah Messenger said. So if this is a mistake happen, it's going to happen by your prophet. The one who is reporting the story is just narrating the story. Allah Messenger said. Who is the one who said the Quran? Allah Messenger too. Who is the one who said this hadith? Allah Messenger too. So your logic fit perfectly, and I encourage you to work with it always, because hallelujah, we got you busted, and we show everybody that Islam is stupid, and we die laughing at your drama. And if you are a man, I challenge you to download this video and you post it in your YouTube. Is that fair, guys? You post it as it is. Don't take anything off. I want you to be proud in front of the Muslims. I want you to show the Muslims how you deeply busted the Christian prince. Okay, hold on, I will go with you. Guys, let us get him busted again. let us get you busted again, Mahmoud. You see, you are my comedy for tonight. Guys, Muhammad said, if you are honest Christians, you are not supposed to be Christians according to Jesus. He said, only came for the lost sheep of Israel. Let me get you busted, you donkey, from the Quran. Because the Quran says that Allah, he gave Jesus the Injil. And the Injil is a Greek word. What does that mean? Listen carefully, Muhammad, and learn how to be spanked from a Christian prince. When Allah, he said that he sent to Jesus the Injil, which is a Greek word, that means the name of the book is a Greek. The name of the book, hold on, the name of the book is what? Is a Greek. How Jesus was sent to the Jews, but yet the name of his book is in Greek? I will explain to you as long as you are silly. The Quran said that Allah never sent a book except to a prophet from the people speaking the tongue of the people. Oh, oops, oof, 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 oof. What does that mean? Chapter 14, verse number 4. We never send a messenger except to speak the language of his own people. So, Abdul, how Allah, he sent the book to the Jews, and Jesus, according to Muslim, was sent to the Jews, but yet the book is in Greek language, brother. I want you right now to ask any Jew, is the word Injil is Hebrew? My friend, he came to his sheep in Israel, yes, and they rejected him, but he said, I have a sheep in other place too. You are ignorant, you do not know the book, and we are laughing at you. This is true if Jesus did not say, and I have sheep in other place. Why you are ignorant? I will tell you, because you are copy-paste. Now you are trying to avoid. Can you answer? Who is a Muslim can answer? How Jesus was sent to the Jews, yet his book is written in Greek. And the Quran confirmed in chapter 14, verse number 4, that Allah never sent a messenger except in the language of his people. But the book is in Greek. That means the Jews are a Greek people. In the book of John, Jesus said, I have sheep in other, place. And that will get you busted. Any Abdul? Who is Abdul? He have an answer for what we just said. Anyone? Who's next? In 2 seconds, you can see how stupid the Quran is. It doesn't match its own. If you go to John chapter 10, verse number 16, you will see it says, and other sheep I have which are not of this fold. Speaking of who? Speaking about the Jews. I am the good shepherd, and I know my sheep, and I know mine, and my sheep, they know me too. As the Father knows me, even so know I and the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. And the other sheep I have, which are not of this fold, to them also I must bring, and they shall hear my voice. Who's next? Well, this guy is, we gave him a chance. I'm not going to speak because I lost my voice screaming. I lost my voice for more than half hour screaming at the end to say to me that he is a donkey. He's a human. You are my witnesses, recorded. Half hour I'm screaming, and to say to me at the end he is a human. You know what? I thought you are a genie, to be honest with you. In the beginning, I thought you are a genie. So all this time is to say to me, you are a human? What does that mean? He want to say to me, I was stupid. I don't know what I'm saying. I call you to get you busted and I turn to be stupid. But that will not work. It's too late. It's recorded. This video will be all over YouTube. And if you are a man, download it when we are done and post it in your YouTube as it is. Is that guys? Is that fair? If he is really proud about his conversation with me, and he claimed that he got me busted, he should pause this video in every Muslim channel. It's a challenge. And don't forget, don't cut anything, because you're Muslim, you do a lot of editing. I'm a human. And you made me confused. No, I answered you. I answered you many times. Here we go. Let me repeat the answer. Let me repeat the answer. My friend, how many times I need to answer you? So what do you want to do? Jump from the window? Do you not like my answer? This is your problem. The books report the stories. Each one of them report what is not mentioned in the other one. So one he says, okay, this is who came and this is the name who came. The other one he added that there is more. So he's adding more information. That's not a contradiction. There's not a single contradiction there. This is your fantasy. Or we are laughing. I answered you. So you will keep saying you did not answer me. You did not answer me. You did not answer me. And actually, you know, when this guy he quote for us John, he quote for us John chapter 20 verse number 1, right? But if you read the verse after, it says we. Correct, guys? Even in John, where he mentioned one name. He mentioned one name, right? But you will see in verse number 2, it says we. Okay, she's saying we. That means there's many. So even in that one, yes, the names are not mentioned, but it mentioned there that there is we. And we mean more than one or two or maybe three or maybe four. Is that correct, guys? No, we got you busted. Mahmoud, does it say in the verse after, does it say we? Does it say we or I'm making things up? If you say no, it doesn't say that, everybody will laugh at you. Let me open them, just wait. So everybody will laugh and see how stupid what when they copy paste. They take a verse, okay, in John chapter 20, verse number 1, it says Mary the Magdalena. Let me play the sound too, an audio, so that will make it more stressful for you. All right. It made me laugh, my friend. Here we go. I will play the audio. Let me see first which one have audio. So everybody will laugh at your contradiction. We laugh at Muslim. When the Muslim they claim contradiction, we laugh. Ignorant talking. Copy-paste. Copy-pastation. In the same time, they are covered to the point they will not apply their own version of logic on themselves. They will not.
John 20. The first day of the week cometh Mary Magdalene early, when it was yet dark, unto the sepulchre, and seeth the stone taken away from the sepulchre. Then she runneth and cometh to Simon Peter, and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and saith unto them, They have taken away the Lord out of the sepulchre, and we know not where they have laid him.
Do you see we know? She is the one who's talking, but they are we. The we, they are the witness. We know not where they have led them. So if she is the lone, who is we who report in the news? That is your fiction. You are desperate trying to find a contradiction. And by the way, this will lead us to other disaster, because this Abdul trying to say to us that the Bible is corrupt. But remember, the Bible is sent by Allah. That means Allah being spanked, and Allah cannot be God. Because if the Bible is corrupt, that means Allah is stupid, and anyone can spank him, change his book, play with it. Right? Do we have any Muhammadan? Who's next? Who's the next victim? Nobody? All right. I will log off Skype. Enough for today with Skype. They are very silly. Copy-paste nation. Let me copy for you. Let me paste for you. And then they got a guy, his name is Phoebe. No, Phoebe. What is wrong with you, man? Speak like a man. And here we go, this guy. He called me. He spoke to me almost for 40 minutes to say to me at the end, I am just a human. I'm so glad you recognize that. I thought you would say you are just a donkey. Because you are not talking like a human. Because a human, he will not say, yes, yes, it is Jibreel, unless he is sure. So why you say yes, and you are sure if it is not sure? All right, now we go back to our topic about the whale, because we were talking about the whale and Mr. Muhammad refused to talk about the whale. Can the Bible speak for themselves? Yeah, it speaks for itself. Here we go. It says there. Can the Quran speak for itself? Can the Quran speak for itself? It cannot. Look at this stupid religion. Look. Chapter 14, verse number 4 says, Allah never send a messenger unless he speak the tongue of the people, from the people. Okay, how Muhammad is a messenger for Indonesia? Can the book speak for itself? How Allah, he said, we never send a messenger except to teach in the language of his own people in order to make things clear to them. Do you see how clear it is for somebody from Somalia like you? Huh? Who you try to act like you know Arabic, supposedly, but you do not speak Arabic really? And then you said to me, oh no, this is not Jibreel, because it says Ruhana, but in the other verse it says Ruhana too, you idiot. And it's recorded. And Quran is not an Arabic word. The one who is saying Quran is an Arabic word. No, Quran is an Aramaic word. Coming from the word Qura'a. You see, this is all coming from the Bible. Muhammad is a thief. If you go to the Christian Aramaic church, you will see, even in Arabic, they say Qira'a, mean Kitab. Qira'a. Qura'a. And Quran cannot be a book. Why? It cannot be the revelation for Muhammad, because qarra wara'a. Let me show you what I mean. Even if you don't speak Arabic, but I will make it simple. I will use English letter. قرأ and رأى. I will add here like something in the top of it. Okay, قرأ is you say like talking. رأى is you see. Together is saying what you read. You understand? So he say in his tongue what he is reading, but Muhammad did not receive a book. So the name of the Quran is wrong. He stole it from the Aramaic Christian. For Muhammad did not know how to read, according to Muslims, and he did not receive a book anyway. So how he is going to have a qira'ah, which is coming from qarra wa ra'a? Now, we go back to our fish, which is seven wheels. Mr. Muhammad, he decided to give us some entertainment, and we have enough, which is good. So, now the question is, we go back to the interpretation. Why in Ibn Kathir interpretation for a chapter, chapter 5 verse number 114, why it says fish while in the Arabic book it says whale? Who, if you remember the story of Prophet Al-Khidr, where he took with him a whale? Who remember it? Just to show you the fiction of Muhammad, how crazy this man is. In there, just to show you how crazy this cult is. Here, this is a story taken from the Bible about a man who a whale swallowed him. Anyone remember who? In Islam, they call him Yunus, but in fact, this name is wrong. Here, supposedly, in translation, they say Jonah, but in the Quran, it doesn't say Jonah, it says Yunus. Who is Yunus? We never heard of this Yunus. In the translation, they translate the word whale as fish, but in Arabic, it says whale. It doesn't say fish. You see how they lie? It says whale. You can ask anyone what the word hoot mean. He will say to you, it's a whale. And everybody knows that there's no way a fish will swallow a man. Right? Big fish. How big? What is the biggest fish? And how? What is the biggest fish can swallow a man and the man stay in the stomach of the fish? The stomach of this fish must be an apartment then. This is, must be a whale. It's a huge. And actually the whale, because it's not a fish, so he have a lot of oxygen inside him. He's not all over water. If you remember the story in chapter 18, verse number 61, it says that Al-Khadr, sorry, Prophet Musa, supposedly, and his servant, they forgot their fish, but it doesn't say fish. In Arabic, it says wheel. Wheel, not fish. And this is a story where supposedly, true story by the way, it happened to me too, where Al-Khadr, Musa's, Allah sent Musa's to meet Al-Khadr so he can learn from him, because Musa's is ignorant. He told him, there's a guy, his name is Al-Khadr. Go and learn from him, brother. He told him, how I'm going to find him? He said, take with you a wheel. And the wheel is dead. When the wheel come back to life, that means you found him. True story, brother. And how the wheel will come back to life, brother? Simply, when they arrive to a spring of water, it's called the water of life. Anyone come in touch with this water will come back alive. And you can, if you don't believe me, this water is true, you can watch the same story in The Pirate of the Caribbean. Look how nice this story is. Unbelievable, brother. So Prophet Musa and his servant, they keep walking with his wheel, and the wheel like walking down the street, but he's dead, you know. So they will take them out, and they by then they would have burnt. Okay, and then a water called Ma'ul Hayat, water of life, will be poured on them. And they will spring out like see the springing, like what is that? Allah will sprinkle water, it's called the water of life, and they will come back to life, brother. True story. This is how Allah, He will make you alive again. He sprinkled water from the fountain of youth. Here in this story, in the other story here, we will find how this whale come back to life. When they arrive, they were like traveling. Musa said to his servant, bring our fish, our meal. Okay, chapter 18, verse number 62. The servant, he went to get the fish. He could not find it. His servant, his name, Yeshua ibn Nun. Look at this. Even the servant, his name, the son of the whale. You remember what Nun mean, guys? Who remember what Nun? Anyone remember the story of Nun? Who remember? Who remember? Let us see. Who of you remember the story of Nun? If you go in the Quran, there is a verse that says, Nun, wal qalam wa ma yasturun. Chapter 68, verse number 1. Let us see the story of Nun. Guys, do you like to see the story of Nun? Who like to see the story of Nun? Give me one, please. Please. Noon, not nonce. Noon. This is the Jordanian government website. Never work. The connection has lost time out. Yeah. This is what happened when you host a website in Jordan. Like, come on, walk. Here we go. Finally, unbelievable. Crazy. very disappointed of them. All right, so we will go to chapter noon. Noon. What happened? Hold on. And brother, now we will show you an interpretation. We'll give you, will drive you crazy. Chapter 61, verse number 1. Please be my witness, brother. And from the narration of the authority of Ibn Abbas, he said, regarding the interpretation of Allah saying noon, he said noon, Allah swear by noon, which is the wheel that carried the earth. Carry what? Actually, no, it's not 61, it's 68, sorry, if I say 61. It is a wheel carrying the earth. True, it's true. I saw it myself. When I was in the island of Lulululu, I saw a whale carrying the earth. The water there was very clear, and I was doing a Scooby-Scooby-Doo diving, you know. I'm very good in Scooby-Scooby-Doo, like, you know. And, like, you know, I went down, and then I saw the whale carrying the earth in the top of it. It was big, a huge whale. And by the way, he could not attack me because he's busy. He cannot move. So I was saying to him, like, come and eat me. And he cannot do anything. Like, the poor whale is just like, boom. Christian Prince, I swear by Allah. One day I will leave the earth and I will come to eat you. Okay, true story. And then, okay, we carry. Look at this, guys. Look at the details. Noon is a whale. Allah swear by a noon. It's a whale carry the earth on its back. Look at this, man. Because if he did not say in its back, you might think in his purse, in his mouth, in his pocket, in his stomach. So praise be to Allah. They wanted to tell us exactly how the whale carrying the earth in the top of its back. Be careful, not in the bottom of its back. While in the water, thank Allah. While in the water, not while in the space. And beneath, okay, which is the bowl? There's what? A bowl. So now we have a whale carrying the earth and a bowl carrying the whale. Okay, hold on. It's time for art. I cannot resist this. I cannot resist this. This is too much to resist. I mean, how in the world I can resist this temptation? So, brother and sister, this is the earth. The earth is a flat, according to the Quran, as you know. So, we cannot say it's a ball, you know. So, this is the earth. And this is, let me draw the whale in different color. So, you will not be confused, because most of you are confused already. Hello, funny people. This is the whale. What happened? This is, it looked like Batman now. This is not a whale. This is Batman. Mask. I never saw a whale like this before. Things happen. Okay, this is, let us make it better this time. Here we go. Bingo, here we go. This is the whale, brother. And brother, in the top of the wheel, there is the earth. And now, under the wheel, there is a ball. Okay, this is need a lot of effort from me to draw it. Okay, so this is the ball. Yeah, ball, ball. Okay, this is Mr. Ball. This is his tail very long, brother. Very, because at that time, tail was very, you know, that was a ball is different. And those are his legs, the ball, you know. I can't show you four legs because we don't have a four dimension for now. I apologize. So this is the whale, and this is the ball. Ball, ball. Okay. And now the whale, it looked like a rat, man. This is not a whale. Honest to Allah, this is look like a rat. Since when the ball look like this? Unbelievable. Guys, this is a ball undercover, okay? Just to let you know. So the ball, actually, his back, to be honest with you, is bigger. I mean, there's a space. How he's going to carry the whale? If there is a space, hello? What's wrong with that, you know? It is, I don't know what, you know, I used to be more artistic before, you know, but since I became very old, I'm losing my hand is not drawing as before. My hand before, I used to like leave my hand in the art room and I go to the kitchen and I come back, the art is done. True story. So, a brother, this Abdul Muhammad is calling me to show me what he think it's contradiction. But you don't see this. Yeah, this is a ball. His name is Rat. Okay, let me put my signature here so nobody can take the art and like you know make it for his own, you know. Hold on. I will make a signature. I will use a special color. Okay, I will use white color so nobody can copy and try to use my signature. Okay, here we go. I'm using white color now. Okay, and this way nobody can see the signature. In the same time, nobody can copy the signature. Okay, thank you very much. If you don't believe me, I'm using white color. Here we go. See, white color. See, so I wrote my signature here in white and white so nobody can copy my signature. Because nobody can see it anyway. Unbelievable. I mean, nobody can do that except us. We are Arab, brother. Arab. Those stories, Arab stories. Who can beat us with those stories? Nobody. Nobody. Nobody, no. Nobody, no. Oh, boy. Okay. So now, brother, we go back to the real story. Beneath which is a ball, and under the ball there is a rock. Rock and roll. Under the ball there's a rock. I mean, come on, put a chair. The poor guy carrying the whale and the whale carrying the earth. I mean, do you know how heavy? And now what is under the ball? A rock. And under the rock is dust. And look here at the honesty. The Muslim, sorry, don't ask us anymore. And none known what is under the dust. Save Allah. Stop. Here the knowledge stopped. That's it. The knowledge of the Muhammadan stopped with this point. They knew that the whale is carrying the earth, yes. They knew that the whale is carried by a ball, yes. They knew under the whale, under the ball, there is a rock, yes. They knew under the rock, there is a dust, yes. But honestly, we do not know more than this. That's it. And here you see the honesty in reporting the story, showing that our limited knowledge is limited. And look, the name of the whale is Lewish, not Lewish Farrakhan. No, this is different Lewish. And it said Its name is Lotia. And the name of the bull is Behemoth. And some say its name is Talahut. Mean. Or Liwan. Liwana. Liwana, Liwana. Where those names are coming from? Those are not Arabic names for sure. Now the word Bahmud, by the way, is mentioned somewhere. You know where it's mentioned? You can search it in the Bible interpretation. You can see it. Here you see how Muhammad and how the crazy is stupid stuff is all over. And the wheel is in the sea called Adwad. Adwad. I was there once. The cult of CP fan base. Muhammad, what cult? Hey, Muhammad, be honest. We are showing you what you Muslims believe, and you are telling me, okay, you know, Muhammad, I'm willing to call you back. If you agree that whoever believe in such a story is a liar, are you willing to do that? Say yes in the chat that you believe that whoever say the story is a liar. Muhammad, do you believe in this story that there is a whale and this whale come back to life for touching the water of youth? Say yes or say no. Are you there, Muhammad? He take vacation now. He will not answer. Small ball in a huge sea. Eesh. The sea in Hollywood Rock, whereby there is 4,000 cracks. Muhammad, those are the cracks in your head right now after calling me. What do you think, Muhammad? Isn't it, this is exactly the same numbers of the cracks you have in your head after calling me? Exactly, brother. And from each crack, there is water spring come out of the earth. And if you want to say that you don't believe in such a garbage, well, your prophet, he is adopting the garbage. And here you see that the whale of Moses, he came back to life. Why? Because the fountain of youth, the fountain of life, sprinkled some water over the whale. So they came back, retracting their star. I mean, what a crazy story. Let us do drawing again, brother. So this is a prophet Moses. And he bent a little down because he's getting older, you know? I'm getting old, you know? Like walking down the street, la 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 la. La 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 la. Okay, now. And by the way, don't think he's Eskimo or anything. No, this is just in the drawing it appeared like this. And then he have his servant with him, and he is carrying a wheel. This is his servant. His servant is not old, so he's like strong, you know. This is his servant. And the wheel in the top of him. Big wheel. They arrive next to a rock. This is the rock. And then the servant, he took the veil from his head and he put it next to the rock. But next to the rock, there is a spring of water. Spring, many springs. Some of the water sprinkle over the fish. When the sprinkles from the spring of the water spring over the fish, over the whale, sorry, the fish come back alive. And now the fish escape. And the fish went inside the ocean, because the ocean is just next door, you know. And when the fish, this is the ocean. See the ocean, he was here, the ocean. This was the ocean. When the fish went inside the ocean, the ocean is big, by the way. It's big. Yeah. So let us see here. We take the fish from here because now the fish is moving, you know, like it's the whale, you know. So the fish went inside the ocean. We will make the fish now, because now she became alive. We will make a different color. Like now she is happy. And actually, no, this is not a good color. I will make it a green. This color is not good. See, I bought this program. It's very useful. Because this is what the prophet named Al-Khudr. Why he's called Al-Khudr? Because he's been touched by this water. So the fish, the whale must be green too. So the whale went in the ocean. And wherever the whale go, the water became like a road. Like a tunnel. Tunnel, you know. So like there's here an opening, and then there is a tunnel. You go inside the tunnel, you know. Tunnel, you know. So this is tunneling land. So Moses, he saw the footsteps of the whale in the water, because the water became solid. Became what? Became solid, became like a rock. So they follow the footsteps of the whale. Now the whale is a swim, by the way, is not walking. But when the whale touched the water, after he leave, the water became rocks, like a tunnel. So Moses and his servant, they follow the steps of the whale, and they enter the tunnel, and they keep walking, until they arrive and they found a guy in the middle of the ocean. There is a rock. In the top of this rock, there was a guy sitting in the top of it. His name, Mahmata Gandhi. His name, a Prophet Al-Khidr. Mr. Green. The reason they call him Mr. Green, because he drank from the water of youth. And anything his ass touch will turn green, even if it's a dry grass. And this is the story in the Quran. And this idiot Muhammad, he wanna prove me wrong. Muhammad is upset that our God was killed by the Roman Empire, but he is not upset that this is his Quran story. Muhammad, let me tell you something about the Roman Empire. You just said that the Roman is the one who killed the Messiah. You mean that Muhammad is a liar and a fraud, because according to the Quran, the one who killed him is the Jews. Secondly, according to the Quran, nobody killed him. Number three, if Jesus cannot be God because he was killed by the Roman, that means he is God in Islam because the Roman could not kill him. How stupid you are. You see, I'm going with your logic. Jesus cannot be God because he was killed by the Roman. If he is God, the Roman cannot kill him. Okay, in Islam, nobody was killing him. No, I don't want you to clarify. You're an idiot. We got you busted. Just take the video and post it. Let everybody laugh at you. We want adults. We don't want kids. After 40 minutes talking to me, you say to me, I am a human? Just to cover your bum for all the stupid things you said to me? Chapter 3 came first, you idiot. People are laughing at you. Yeah, but Jesus said, I lay down myself, nobody take my life. And the Bible says, just Jesus knew who is going to give him up, who will betray him, even what time they will come and arrest him. So if Jesus wants, he can run away. But he's not a coward. Sorry guys, I'm losing my voice. I'm not going to stay longer. I can tell soon my voice will be gone. I drank too much coffee today. So as you see, this is what the Muhammadan believe in. How in the world anyone can believe in such a garbage? You want to believe in Christianity, you don't want to believe in Christianity, this is your business. But this is garbage. Literally. The story is in front of you, and the same story is mentioned in the Quran. Fountain of youth, you drink from it, you come back to life. And then you should read this, the rest of the story. Unbelievable. A sparrow, okay, a sparrow, who? A sparrow came and he make a hole in the ship. Have you ever heard of a sparrow? Can make a hole in the ship. I mean, the peak of the sparrow became a chisel suddenly. A sparrow. Me. In case you not know what the sparrow is, I'm going to search Google for you. Brother. Sparrow, sparrow. Sparrow here, sparrow, sparrow, sparrow everywhere. Hold on, let me find a sparrow for you. A sparrow, he opened a hole in the ship by his beak. May Allah peak you. I mean, are you serious? This little tiny thing in the size of my toes, he opened a hole in the ship. I mean, don't you think the story is so big to be swallowed? Your prophet, his lies is beyond imagination. A sparrow, make it an eagle. Make it the woodpecker. A sparrow. He opened a hole in a ship. Guys, I did read that the Titanic drowned because of a sparrow. A sparrow came to the Titanic ship, and he did like cuckoo, 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 and he made a big hole, and then the water was coming like crazy inside the ship. A sparrow. I mean, I never saw a big fat liar bigger than your prophet. I'm just talking to him to understand what happened. Oh, okay. Guys, he's saying it was not him who did that hole. It was his cousin. His name is Murphy. Let me ask him more. Okay. Ah. All right, I got it. I got it. He's saying his cousin Murphy, he was not really making a hole in the ship, but he was trying to charge his phone, and he saw under the wood there is a charger cable, you know. So he was trying to pick it up. Okay, let's see if he will tell us more. Ah, and then he said, but his mom, she told him, don't charge your phone because I got your new phone. So he made the hole and he did not fix it, and this is how he made the hole. True story. Sparrow. Sparrow. So we have a ship, and Mr. Sparrow, he made a hole in the floor of the ship, and then when the pirate they came, they did not take the ship because there's a hole in it, it's going to be drawn. It must be big hole in your head. Let us see. All right, I found a great example for you, Ibrana and Thithar. So I can show you exactly what happened. Oh boy. All right, this is the boat, brother. Then the sparrow, he landed in the top of the boat. And he started like boo boo cuckoo, 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 and he opened a hole, and the water was gushing forth. Tell me about your childhood problem from Egypt. Yeah, I will tell you my childhood problem. I was kicked out from my uncle's house like your prophet. And they sent me to the desert because nobody would nurse me. So they get rid of me because nobody in the family accept me. Are you talking about your prophet? I'm not from Egypt, you idiot. Secondly, the one who have a problem in his childhood is your prophet. Isn't it you Muslim, you say that his family they dumped him and nobody wanna take him and nobody wanna nurse him? I mean, how much you love your child to the point not even a single woman in the town wanna nurse him. They give him to a strange woman in the Bedouin so they can get rid of him. Why? Because nobody accept him to be the son of that man. This woman, she is lying. She is not, she this is not the son of the husband they claim. The father of Muhammad, he died 3 months after marrying, or let's say sleeping with the mother of Muhammad, supposedly. But his mother, she gave birth to him 4 years after his death. Childhood? Tell me about your childhood problem, brother. Please tell me. Stupidity. Any Muslim have an? By the way, I like this ship, but I was going to buy one. By the way, I'm very rich, brother. I was going to be yacht. There's a big yacht, like for like $10 million. I told them, "Can you accept cash?" They said no. I said, "So too bad." Otherwise, I was going to buy it right away. But in the same time, I hesitated because I was worried that a sparrow would stop in the top of my 90-meter yacht, and he will make a hole in it. And you can imagine what will happen next. after all the money I paid, then a yacht is going to be like gone because of a sparrow. No, I'm scared. I don't talk to kids. You are a kid. You've been spanked. That's it. You see, here we burn papers. You know papers? We light you up, we burn you, and then we throw you away. Your history. Why I want to waste my time with somebody I burned already and my fingers is still showing in his bum? Let me tell you why you are desperate. When people, they gamble and they lose, they go crazy. And this is exactly what happened. Everybody heard my answer. Everybody heard your answer. And people will judge. Here we go. Now he is talking about the gurus and etc. Okay, it's time for you to go. Let me send you. Here we go. When I talk about fangirls, your prophet, he ordered all every Muslim woman to give her private part to him. Shame on you. Which means your mother, if she exists, your father, he have to give her to Muhammad. Ibn al-Arabi said that if the prophet, his eyes fall into a woman, her husband must divorce her immediately. You believe it? And you are talking about fan? If your mother, the eyes of the prophet fall into her bum, and he like her bum, your father have to divorce her immediately. And I can show you the reference, and you can read it right now. So the prophet, he can take her. And by the way, if I have fans and they are girls according to you, okay, I'm very handsome, brother. can't you tell? Abdul, I am single. Your prophet have 13 crazy wives, and yet he is asking for more. And you are talking about there's girls who they are my fan. So what if there's girls my fan? Is that a crime? I have girls, I have men too. So? So, this is what you have against me, brother. What a stupid idiot. That's supposedly now, he's like, this is embarrassing. Christian Prince, you have fan, they are girls. I'm very handsome. Well, I don't know why you don't call my mom and tell her about how handsome I am. I mean, nobody can convince her. I tried. Even I sent her pictures of from magazine, told her this is how I became now. After you came to America, she did not believe it. I don't know why. You know, like we did some Photoshop. Like actually, these days you don't know how people look like. Everybody, but they have phones, especially like Chinese phones. They have tons of apps, and then the women, they take pictures of themselves and then they post it in Facebook. And you look at this girl, who is this girl? Who is this girl? I mean, she looked like someone I know, but look, her eyes is way bigger and her lips is way different and her nose is really different and everything is different. Even she is taller. Do you have coronavirus? Well, I have coronavirus. I have coronavirus. I did destroy all the virus. And the biggest virus I am destroying right now is Islam. Who care about coronavirus? We people, we will die once. Anyone is coughing for you right now, he have coronavirus. To give you an idea. We Arab, we used to fish by our beard. Because our beard is very complicated. So we go in a boat like this in the ocean. And then we throw our beard in the water. And then the whale will be trapped inside the beard. If you don't believe me, open Sahih al-Bukhari. I mean, why Muslims, they believe in Sahih al-Bukhari stories, but they don't believe in my stories? Open the Quran. I mean, you have all the crazy stories. Why my story is not, why nobody is convinced of my story? Why? Should I give it like a number, like a, I say Quran, chapter, etc., that make you agree? If I say Prophet Muhammad say this story, immediately you say, believe, brother, I believe. Here we go. Fountain of youth. The whale, he walked in the water. He made a tunnel. Moses walked inside the water in the tunnel. He go inside the ocean. He found a guy sitting in the top of a rock. And what is the name of the guy? Al-Khudr, which means Mr. Green. And why his name is Mr. Green? Because he drank from the water of youth. And why is that? Call him a drink still. Because after he drank from the water of youth, if he sweat, he will make from his ass, he will make the dry grass green. So they call him Mr. Green. Oh boy. All right, guys. Did we have a good time? Okay, thank God today people behaved and we did not see fight in the chat. And again, anyone really will be bad and rude, people start fighting, I will ban them. I will clean the chat. I prefer to have 10 clean people better than having 100 immature, stupid people. What we do here is very important. Extremely important. And I don't have really the time or the patience to focus out of my mission. So anyone here is welcome as long as you are coming to support what I do. If you are a Muslim, I understand you have to oppose me. So you have the free, you know, feel free. I mean, you are a Muslim. But if you are not, why you are coming to disturb what we do here? Anyone, he will take us away from our topic, start fighting in the chat, I consider him working for the devil trying to disturb my mission. And I will block you immediately. Nobody fight with anyone. We are not kids. If somebody don't like what he say, click at his name, click a block, you will not see any of his text. As simple as that. And Brother Sam Shamoon, I saw some, they are complaining, saying Sam Shamoon abusing Christian. You know, be honest with yourself. A person who spent hours and hours, tens of thousands of hours from his life, explaining, teaching, and defending the Bible. So from the tens of thousands of hours, you found 1 minute of his talking you did not like, and that make him abusing the Christians? As I said before, if Sam Shamoon was a Muslim, the Muslim, they will make a big mosque for him in the middle of Mecca, in the name of Sam Shamoon. You should support this poor guy. I encourage you actually to donate to him. He's a poor man. He's literally poor. He don't even have a house. He live in, as I know, he live in the brother, his brother house. Support the man, a poor man, very decent, a warrior. He speak from his heart. Maybe he don't have patience like me, but that does not make him bad. He get angry actually from Christians because he is very passionate. You see, when you are very passionate about what you do, and then somebody come and he do play like kid or act like ignorant. Support this poor man. If he is tough with you, not because he hate you. Actually, those who get angry very fast, they have a good heart. They forget after 2 seconds. They scream loud and then you think like they're going crazy. But after 2 seconds, he will give you a hug. So don't be a fool and don't side with the devil against a Christian warrior. All of us, sometimes we say things maybe we should not say. So all the good things he do will not forgive for him. If he was a little bit upset with you and he said a rude word with you, okay. Where is the Christians who forgive and we love our enemy? And suddenly we became enemy to him, and we want to make videos against him. That is a shame. Yeah, and Sam Shamoon, he say things in his mouth as it is. He's not politically correct, and he dump it as it is. For some, this is too much. If you don't like what he do, don't go there. I mean, who's forcing you? I mean, people are really weird. The guy is giving from his time voluntarily. Instead of saying to him, thank you, we complain, but doesn't make him bad. Yeah, Sahih a Christian, he knew him in real life, He's a good man. We should support anyone who is really fighting for a truth. We are here to compete, to fight the devil, not to fight each other. Any Christian fight with a Christian, he is not serving Christ. All right? So donate for him if you can donate. Help him, support him. The guy, he deserves our support. Anything else before we go? All right, Satu. Okay, guys, I want to say thank you for being here. I really love you all, except like 99.999% of you. And I really appreciate you all, except 99.9999.9999 on you. And I really like to see you again, except 1,000,000% of you. And now the Muslim, they will make a video and they will say Christian prince abusing the Christians. I want to abuse you all of you. A lot of abuse. I'm going to bring you to my house and I will force you to eat my cooking. And that will be called food abuse. And not only that, I will bring Zakir Naik and he will speak in the top of your food, which means it's going to be full with corona. Zakir Naik, you want to make a speech before they start eating all this fancy food? I don't spit. When I speak, all the bubbles come out. But this is because I'm healthy. And I speak for healthy. And secondly, you are a liar. I don't spit at all. The water comes from my mouth, it's called a sprinkler. It's called what? Sprinkler. Sprinkler, you stupid. You don't speak English, you don't speak Arabic, I know this is coming. And, Elijah means God is with us in Hebrew. Oh, okay. All right. May the Lord bless us all. Love each other. Forgive each other. And, we who do this fight, we have a lot of stress. We do not need more people to make stress on us. So, you watch David Wood, you watch Sam Shamoon, you watch my videos. They have a lot of stress. They do not need more. So understand always that you have a duty, at least not to give them stress, at least. If you can't do nothing to help them, and you cannot do nothing to fight with them, don't be against them. That is a shame. Support the good ones. For the good ones are fighting for all of us, not for them. I want to say thank you all, and may the Lord bless you, and I will see you soon again. Christ is Lord. Islam is false. And please don't forget to subscribe to our account, which is Quality of Life, where we go every Friday, Saturday, Sunday, live on air there, and the topic is not Islam. So if you'd like to join us in that channel, search for Quality of Life M27, as you see in the screen, and join us and subscribe. Thank you very much. Christ is Lord. Islam is false. And we prove it every day. Thank you.